Hey friends, welcome to Northview Kids TV Online. I'm so excited that you decided to join us today. We have so many great things planned, so why don't we jump right on in? Let's go.
In your court, you will greet me. And you'll find me not guilty. You will look me in the eyes, say, my child, you're justified.
Miss Nadja.
And I am Melman!
And Melman, I have noticed that you brought something along with you today. What is this?
Oh, this is my running trophy. I really wanted to show it to you.
Oh, this looks awesome. How did you get this running trophy?
Well, my coach gave it to me because I was the best runner on the team. And some people said I was so fast that they called me Lightning!
Wow, that is an awesome nickname, Melman. And did you find it hard to be the best runner?
Oh, some days it was hard. I had to practice a lot and put in a lot of hard work to become a fast runner.
Yeah, that's really cool though that you could be the best runner. Did you know in our Bible story today, we are learning about someone who's the best priest?
Oh, is that person Jesus?
You are totally right, Melman. It is Jesus. And we already know that Jesus is the best prophet, and today we're gonna learn all about how he is the best priest.
Oh, that sounds so cool. I really wanna hear more.
Okay, then why don't we go listen to our Bible story together and we can learn all about it.
Oh, sounds like a plan, Stan.
Okay, let's go.
The early church was made up of almost all Jewish believers who were persecuted for following Jesus. Because their lives had become difficult, many believers began to wonder if following Jesus was worth it. Some may have even thought about giving up on Jesus altogether.
In the past, God's people, the nation of Israel, were led by priests. Priests led the people to worship God through sacrifices. Aaron the Levite and his descendants were priests.
The Holy Spirit helped a Christian leader write words of encouragement to the early church in the book of Hebrews. The author of Hebrews told Jesus' followers that Jesus is better. Jesus became like us in every way so he could become a merciful and faithful high priest for us. Because Jesus suffered and was tempted, he is able to help us when we are tempted.
The writer of Hebrews reminded the believers about Melchizedek. Melchizedek is the first person in the Bible to be called a priest. This is what the author wrote.
We know Melchizedek was greater than Aaron, the first chief priest of Israel, because Abraham gave him a tenth of his treasure. Melchizedek, the king of Salem and priest of the God Most High, reminds us of Jesus, the Son of God. Aaron and all the priests who came after him were men who died. Jesus is our priest who lives forever.
The priesthood of Aaron and the Levites, who made sacrifices for the sins of the people, was not enough to save them forever. The law set up as priests men who were weak, limited by their sin and by death. Their work pointed forward to a greater priest, Jesus. Jesus fulfilled God's promise and became the perfect sacrifice. Now we have a perfect priest forever.
Jesus is able to save completely those who come to God through him, since he will never die again. He always lives to intercede for them.
Jesus is the priest we need. He is holy and without sin. Jesus doesn't need to offer sacrifices every day, as high priests do. First for their own sins, then for those of the people. Jesus did this once and for all time when he offered himself. God sent to us his Son, our perfect priest forever.
Jesus is the perfect priest. The high priest who interceded on behalf of the people by laying down his life to be a once and for all sacrifice for sin. Everyone who trusts in Jesus has salvation from sin through his perfect life, death, and resurrection.
It's time to learn our memory verse. I'm gonna do the actions and the words will be on the screen, so I'd love it if you said it nice and loud with me. Here we go.
We have a high priest who can feel it when we are weak and hurting. We have a high priest who has been tempted in every way, just as we are. But he did not sin. Hebrews 4, verse 15. Awesome job. Let's do it one more time together. Say it nice and loud and do some really big actions. Here we go. We have a high priest who can feel it when we are weak and hurting. We have a high priest who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, but he did not sin. Hebrews 4, verse 15. Awesome job. Happy memorizing.
I will sing forever of your love, come down. With my hands to heaven, shout your praises loud. I was lost in darkness when you pulled me out. I will sing forever of your love, come down. I once was blind, I could not see. Chains of sin had shackled me, but God in heaven heard my plea. Then Jesus, Jesus, rescue me. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, rescue me. I'll sing forever of your love, come down.
Friends, what a sweet service we just had. Thanks so much for joining us. Don't forget to do the discussion questions at the end. But before we go, let's take some time to pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this day that you have made. Thank you that you have given us your word that we can read and learn about you and your son, Jesus. We love you so much. And all God's children said, amen. See you next time.